am such a fan still of Jon Favreau's The Jungle Book that I have a hard time understanding why we need Andy Serkis's. I mean, I love Andy Serkis. He was so good in Black Panther. And I think that Breathe from last year was a pretty good, like, starter film. I mean, the guy's definitely talented in front of and behind the camera. So, I don't know. Maybe this movie can carve some space out for itself. I don't think it can be anywhere near as financially successful as Jon Favreau and Disney's The Jungle Book. That movie came so close to $1 billion. But this has an October release date. Perhaps this can be more of an awards contender where the first Jungle Book was not. The first, you know, well, live action. These are mostly animated movies. Which was a shame, by the way. I thought Jon Favreau's Jungle Book should have been more of a contender. But, you know, of course, Andy Serkis, I think, has a deeper awards Rolodex. So let's take a look. This first shot's very compelling. But again, the Jon Favreau's is so good, and it was so good that Disney re-upped him for a Lion King one afterwards. Let's see if this seems distinct enough that we can enjoy both of them.
I only heard stories about the jungle. I lived in a king's palace in a cage just like this. I bit and I scratched. And I spent my entire life fighting.
Oh, he's like an animal, get it?
So one day, I just stopped. And I gained their trust. Gained their trust, little brother. The jungle is no longer safe for you. You must stay in the village. It will be all right. Little brother.
I've already seen that scene.
When I found you, all those seasons ago, I thought I could teach you how to belong. But I was wrong, Mowgli. My, how you've grown.
That tiger doesn't look real, which is crazy.
Something the jungle has never seen before.
That's a nice title card. You know what this reminds me of? It reminds me an awful lot of what Jon Favreau just made. It looks so similar. I mean, you could intercut some shots and you would think it was the same movie. And I think that was a ridiculous choice on the part of Warner Brothers. But it also reminds me of the Tarzan movie that came out recently, right? That was pretty good. I mean, this little Mowgli kid, Rohan Chand, he's the one from that Jason Bateman movie? Bad Words. Wow, he's a good actor. He seems very different here. He seems very, very Alexander Skarsgård as Tarzan. I was impressed with the pose he was able to strike there, especially towards the end. But it almost makes me wish they just threw all this money and talent into another Tarzan movie, because the first one was pretty good. I mean, a lot of audiences supported that film, even though critics didn't, and the media didn't, you know, but the people said, I like Alexander Skarsgård as Tarzan. But the people have already thrown their weight behind Disney's The Jungle Book. So this just, it just seems, I mean, I think that Warner Brothers should have been like, I know you want to play blew real bad, Andy, and you've put a lot of effort into this already, but I think we might have to scrap it. It's just too similar to The Jungle Book. I'll see it, you know, not only because, you know, to cover it, but also just because I'm a cinephile, and so I would want to see what Andy Serkis has done here. But for the most part, can you see yourself spending money on this in theaters? I mean, I guess if you're going to see it, you should see it on the big screen, but it's a shame because, again, there's so much talent here. Behind, you know, the voice work is amazing. You know, Benedict Cumberbatch is Shere Khan. But don't you agree also the animals, when you looked at them up close, they looked cartoonish, which I thought was also an odd choice. But we'll see. And also, Andy Serkis is Baloo. He didn't showcase himself, which I also think is weird because, you know, everybody's into Andy Serkis right now, especially coming off of Black Panther. So write your thoughts down below. Thank you for watching with me, and you can check out some more videos right now.